Hello, and welcome to the 8th Ghost Light Tour of the Smith Opera House in Geneva, New York. Since you can't come to the Smith right now for our history tours, we'll bring the history to you. I'm Chris Woodworth, and I'll be your tour guide. I want to take a moment to thank Gretty Hollister, who contributed a portion of the research for this week's episode. So without further ado, here's episode 8. Who built it? When you walk through the front doors of the Smith, you move through the vestibule, past the old box office, and into the lobby. As you look around, you likely notice the gleaming gold angularity of a distinct period of design, Art Deco. Art Deco was the 1920s style that you might associate with an age of speakeasies and jazz music. It drew its inspiration from all things mechanized and modern. This style was highly theatrical, full of classical, symmetrical, and rectilinear elements inspired by artistic movements such as Cubism, Futurism, and even Art Nouveau. Despite all of these influences, though, Art Deco was unique and became the style of the Roaring Twenties across the U.S., from architecture to automobiles to fashion. These motifs spread as far as our very own Geneva, New York, when Victor A. Rigamont, the architect behind Shine's Geneva Theater, integrated Art Deco styles into the theater during its 1931 reconstruction. The box office's symmetry and streamlined physique provide a handsome example of Art Deco. These motifs and colors decorate the vestibule, from the wall decorations at the east and west elevations to the ceiling. The lobby carpet, a deep red with gold swirls, helps take the audience back in time. Lighting fixtures boast straight lines and geometric symmetry throughout the lobby as well as in the balcony. In the late 1990s, the interior of the Smith was restored, returning us to the shimmering glory of the 1931 reinvention of the Opera House as a movie palace. But who was responsible for bringing Rigamont's Art Deco designs to life? The Finger Lakes Association published a souvenir program to commemorate the reopening of the Smith Opera House as Shine's Geneva Theater, March 17, 1931. Copies of this program can be found at the Geneva Historical Society, or, if you're lucky, you may find one up for sale on eBay. A perusal of the businesses and contractors who placed an ad in the program tell us who worked on the renovation and remodel from 1930 to 1931. Coordinating the entire construction project was Morell Vrooman Incorporated from Gloversville, New York, engineers and contractors, who simply noted that Shine's Geneva Theater was built by them. We know from last week's episode that the steelwork in this renovation was undertaken by the Smith and Caffrey Company of Syracuse. Area companies assisted with some of the other major structural elements of the renovation. Nicholas Coblio, general contractor, declared, "We cleared the ground and put in the foundations." Several businesses shared the ways in which they delivered structural supplies. "We supplied all common brick used in this theater," noted P. O'Malley & Son, Coal & Supply Company. S. and T.D. Beard, Mason Supplies, provided 60 tons plaster, 5,500 sacks cement, 15,000 hollow building tile, 2,000 pounds black mortar color, 2,000 pounds red mortar color in building this beautiful edifice. R.J. Rogers Lumber Company furnished the lumber used in construction. Dillingham & Son Incorporated, Hardware and Housewares, declared, "We were privileged to supply the heavy hardware for this beautiful edifice," while Dorchester & Rose Hardware indicated, "We are proud to have furnished the hardware." Many of the ads reveal the complexities of heating and cooling such a large structure in 1931. John A. Pontius, Steel Metal Work, boasted, "Our part in this fine edifice was the installation of ventilating fans for circulating and cleansing the air." And one of those giant fans is still in operation today. In the summer of 2018, however, the Smith had to replace the other one as part of approximately $56,000 worth of unexpected repairs to the air conditioning system, which was added to the building in 2013. Riggs & Jensen, sanitary and heating engineers, installed the heating and plumbing in this fine theater. "All of the electrical equipment, wiring, etc., was installed by us," announced Page Electric Company. Remember that swirling design on the lobby carpet? The company responsible for the installation may sound familiar because their furniture store is still located on Exchange Street in Geneva. The luxurious carpet you will walk on in this truly beautiful theater was installed by us, said Lynch Brothers. Many other businesses were also responsible for the interior decorative elements of the reconstruction. J.G. Henry & Son, contractor and builder, noted, "We are proud to have done the carpenter work and interior trim on this beautiful building." Fairfax Brothers Company Paint Headquarters declared, "This beautiful theater is decorated with Sherwin-Williams paints and varnishes, which Boyd Decorating Company put to use as they stated, we did the general painting and the decorating of offices and stores." And all of this was finished off by the Continental Decorating Company from Chicago, Illinois, who said, "We are proud of the decorating work we did on the magnificent theater." And indeed, the new Shines Geneva Theater was and is truly magnificent. Where else can you watch a film or live performance indoors and yet under the stars? For more information on the history of the Smith Opera House, please visit our history blog, which can be found on our website, thesmith.org. You can also learn how to become a member of the Smith and how to make a donation. We'll see you next time for another ghost-like glimpse of the history of the Smith.